Okay, this is the May 16th meeting of the Conway Select Board. I'd like to open the meeting at 6:30. First item, we'd like to welcome our newest selectman, Bob Armstrong, to the board.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Bob. Or as Bob told you earlier, condolences, depending upon the day. Okay, our next item on the agenda is our minutes for the May 9th meeting. Bob, did you have a chance to look those
over? Yes, you had fine to me.
Okay. Yeah, they look good. I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes for the May 9th meeting. Do I have a second?
Yes.
Okay. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay. No, you can't vote on that.
I can't vote.
Well, you weren't here for that.
I wasn't here.
Yeah.
Everybody watched it on TV though.
Okay. That's encouraging. You're one of the three people that did. Okay. Next item on the agenda is the warrants for, we have a vendor warrant for $113,719, payroll warrant for $99,811, and a payroll deduction warrant for $25,806. I'll make a motion that we approve those warrants.
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Next item, meetings attended by select board members. Bob, did you attend anything last week?
Mm-hmm.
No, neither did I. Okay. We have any citizens' concerns? Seeing none. Okay, we don't have any old business. Next item, some new business. First item is to elect a chair and a clerk of the board. Do we have any nominations?
So can I nominate John for chair?
Do we have any seconds?
Second.
Okay.
If you want it, you want it?
Sure. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
My condolences to you.
I will nominate Bob as the clerk of the board. Do I have a second?
Which Bob?
Oh.
Bob Baker.
Robert.
Robert Baker. I will nominate Robert Baker as the clerk of the board. Do I have a second?
I'd second that.
Okay. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Okay. Now we have two Bobs on the board. Okay.
Really going to get you confused.
Okay. We have to assign regional representation. Do you have a list of those, Tom?
It's right there.
Oh, sorry, it's in the email.
Okay, Frontier Community Access Television. Bob Armstrong is the chair of the board of directors for that, so I think we should elect him as the representative for the board.
So do we only get one?
Well, okay.
I mean, because you're also on the board.
I'm also a representative. Now, I am the representative of the select board.
Right.
You're the representative of
the broadband committee.
The broadband committee.
And we get officially both
right
positions.
Yes.
Right. Are those the only two positions the town's?
No, the town has four, I think.
No, there's three.
Three.
There's one from the broadband, one from the select board, one from the school. And the school position is vacant right now.
I think it's technically Mike.
Well, okay, Mike. I don't know whether he is actually approved by the school.
That legal has two selectmen on one board.
Well, yeah. If you're not deliberating on Conway business,
yeah.
It should be okay, but it should. That might be something to check with Jenny about for a disclosure form.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll do that.
So we just leave it that way. I'll be for the broadband committee and you for the select board.
That's fine. Okay.
Second those motions.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Next item is the Franklin Regional Council of Governments. Well, I'm the chair of the council of the Franklin Regional Council of Government, so it's logical that I should stay in that position.
Sounds good to me.
Okay. Well, I can't really make that motion.
I'll make a motion to John B. fulfill the position. You have a second?
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, next item is the Upper Pioneer Valley Veterans Services Rep. I am the Veterans Services Rep for Conway. And I can continue in that position.
Good.
Okay.
I'll make a motion to place John as the
second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, next item is the Franklin Regional Transit Authority. I am the representative for the Franklin Regional Transit Authority for Conway.
Do you want that still?
It's...
When do they meet?
They meet about four times a year. Would you like to be that rep?
As long as they don't meet on Wednesday nights, I'd be golden.
I think they have a Tuesday or Thursday night meeting, if I'm not mistaken. Would you like to be the rep, Bob?
Right.
Okay, I'll nominate Bob as the Franklin Regional Transit County Transit Authority rep for Conway.
Second.
Okay, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, the next item is the Greater Franklin Regional Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy Advisory Committee.
That's a mouthful.
Okay. Bob, why don't you take that?
Okay.
Okay.
I'll second that.
All right. You have a nice
Was this one that Jim did before?
Excuse me?
Was this one that Jim did before?
You know what?
It doesn't matter. I understand.
I don't know.
We had a representative from the select board who resigned the position, who was doing that. It was Pamela O'Brien.
Oh, Pam, right, that's right. Pam was doing that. We had appointed her to that position.
Yeah. And
right.
She resigned from that. So.
Okay. All right, I'll make a motion that Bob Armstrong be the rep for the Greater Franklin Regional Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy Advisory Committee.
Second.
Whatever that is.
We'll find out.
Okay.
John,
in favor.
Is there all appointments until June 30th, 2017?
These appointments are, yes, until, next year. Okay. All right, that's all we have for regional appointments.
And we do not have Peggy in.
And we do not have
yet.
Peggy in. Okay, so next item on the agenda is to sign the agreement with the engineering firm for Delabar Avenue. And we have two contracts to sign. These contracts have been vetted by our town council, and he's given us approval on them.
Yeah, it's two copies of one contract.
Right.
So it's the same.
Cool. All right, now you know what this is, Bob. This
I went and looked at it today.
Okay. Yeah, this is the erosion better. Up on Delabar.
You can't miss it. Yeah. Some
major improvements need to be done there.
Yeah, there's a couple of spots along Delabar that are severely eroding. We have to do something about that, or we're going to lose portions of that road.
They're still on board about applying for the application for the. Mitigation grant, right?
Yes. One of the things that I didn't mention at town meeting because I didn't want to maybe bring people's hopes up falsely, or it is the intent. The reason this is going quickly like this now is we want to submit this by in the next couple of weeks, which is the time for getting in the FEMA Hazard Mitigation Grant, which is administered by MEMA.
Mm-hmm.
There's just a couple week turnaround on this.
Right. And you saw my email that I have registered.
Yes, and okay. I replied to them, so all of that ought to be in place now.
Okay. All right. I'll make a motion that we approve and sign these contracts with GZA. For engineering for Delabar Avenue. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. So these were about 40,000?
42.
No, what I remember, 42, yeah.
Oh, 41 something, isn't it?
A hair under, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
We rounded it off to 42.
While I'm signing these, Tom, why don't you take the next item, review the schedule to consider a biweekly meeting schedule?
Yes. Typically, when it's not budget season, a biweekly meeting schedule is sufficient for doing the work of the board. We generally do our warrants every 2 weeks, so we have the select board meeting on the evening that the warrants are done, so everybody gets paid in the most timely manner possible. So
that's for the months of July and August?
That's from now until budget season starts. Yeah.
So this will be the last one this month?
No. Memorial Day falls on a Monday, but okay. We do have to do the warrants, so that would be a
Tuesday meeting
on the 31st. But aside from that, it's every other Monday. And any Monday holidays, it's the problem with having meetings on Monday nights is we get bumped fairly regularly. But,
so these wouldn't follow like a first and third schedule, they're just every other week.
And we really do need to get the bills out every other week, so that's why.
And when would that start?
Some towns don't do it that way, but it's nice to keep the businesses we employ happy.
So next week it won't be rain.
Okay, that's right.
Yeah.
And then Memorial Day.
Great. I'll make a motion we accept Tom's proposal for bi-weekly from now through to the end of August.
Well, I was saying until budget season starts, which is when you really need it.
Yeah, but that's not until what, in December?
Oh, the season starts before then. I would say November at the latest.
I know, past years we always they went just through the summer, didn't they?
It depends. Generally, the department heads aren't required to get their budgets in until the end of the year. I've been trying to move that up a little bit. It would be nice if we had the budgets available in December, and many towns do, so I'm happy moving it up and starting it in November.
I have concerns about that, but being a department head.
Well, I mean, some people start the process
earlier.
Some people start the process in August, you know, and expect things to be in by, you know, October. But and then
I'm just wondering if it's
extensive hearings.
Going back to your biweekly, I'm just wondering if that's just too long a span to go biweekly up until almost late November.
Well, it hasn't been, and I don't think it was.
Do last year. We can adjust it if the need arises. Yeah. All right. From here on, we'll
until you decide you want weekly meetings,
biweekly schedule.
Sounds good to me.
All right.
Whatever works best for you.
Next item is to review the revised field use policy. Has everybody had a chance to look this policy over?
Yes.
And of course, all policies are amendable over time.
Mm-hmm.
But what I did was kind of update the one from 2002. I incorporated a lot of Buckland's. And you see the underlying sections are the ones that I brought in from Buckland. So they seem to have thought things out very thoroughly there.
Okay.
I also added the fee schedule to this document and have a separate application form that goes along with it rather than having people just sign the policy, which is also a good thing, but also having the form itself to submit. And again, there can be, greater or smaller amendments made to these. Some of them would be just administrative, but if there were a policy change, of course, I'd bring it back to the board.
How many ball field rentals did we have last year?
We had none.
Okay.
We have one coming up, which is...
Right. We have one coming up. And it's we maybe have one or two a year, normally.
Well, we haven't had any that have... been formally that have gone through the formal process. Again, this was something that previously went through the Recreation Committee and managed it. And due to their own reorganization at this point, rather than asking them to take it on, I thought going through this office would be the most efficient thing to do at this point.
Okay. I've read this policy. It looks fine to me. I'll make a motion that we approve the proposed ball field rental and fee policy that's been proposed by our town administrator. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Okay, Highway Department, report on bridges. Take it away, Ron.
Now, this is just to give an update on what we have going on with the bridges. We have 13 bridges. Most of them are in pretty decent shape, but we have one that's real bad and one that's not that great either, but the one that's real bad is the second one on Poland Road,
right,
which we've had problems in the past. And
right. Is that, that's the one we have shored up?
Yes.
Yeah, that's North Poland Road, right?
North Poland Road, yeah. Mm-hmm. Number two bridge on North Poland Road. And I'm in the process of working with the state right now to find out our best course to go. I had the impression that if we had got a design for it, that that may be the best option for the state coming up, finding money to replace it if we already had ready-to-go plans.
Mm-hmm.
That's now since changed, or I shouldn't say changed. He's supposed to be finding out. Things have changed in Boston, how they do things with money. I'm guessing they're finding it hard to find money to. So this week I'm supposed to call him back and find out what he found out, and he's going to suggest probably our best course of action.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Is that kind of a ready-made set of plans that he did on bridge number three on the same road?
Is that what?
Was that a already canned set of plans that they had?
No, they had an engineering firm do it. They actually...
They did, very short time frame. They worked on engineering for a year, that's right, though.
Well, no, the engineering's been 10 years now, once from when they started. There is 80% plans for this bridge, number two bridge, because originally they were going to do all three bridges.
Mm-hmm. Right, yeah.
I think there's... The first bridge is already at the 75% approval stage. The second bridge is at 80% of the 75%.
Okay.
You know, because at 75%, I guess they bring it to the town for public hearings before
they finish. So they're actually further ahead by the first bridge than they were the second one.
Yeah. So that may help us in, because if the plans that they started actually may be a big plus for us if we use that company. And he did say, I talked to the company that did the plans or were working on them, and they pretty much said that there's been a lot of changes since, so mm-hmm. they'd actually have to go back to the beginning and, you know, go through their plans to see if there's any places that they need to change. But I don't know where that leaves us money wise or anything at this mm-hmm. point. But other than that, the only other question I actually had for Bob on Bardo's Ferry Bridge, they got it listed as our bridge, but we only own the approach.
We only own the first section of our approach, but they listed it, and I'm not going to say this right, they listed it as a Conway Bridge because of the historic nature of it. I believe we got some sort of historic grant when they did that. They paid the whole amount of that. And for some reason, Conway had to apply for the historical application for that, for some reason. Shelburne couldn't, and I can't answer the whole question.
I'll talk to the guy.
If I remember correctly, that's what was up with that.
You know,
Conway had to be like what do you want to call it, leader in getting this bridge off the ground more than Shelburne. Yeah, even though 90% of the bridge is in Shelburne.
About what year was that?
Well, the bridge was rebuilt in 1995.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so that was the event. Okay.
Yeah, it seems to be getting a little bit rickety.
No, I just had an inspection on it. There's actually what seems to be one of the biggest problems with the bridge is the damage it was done before it was officially open from the truck.
Planks are getting a whisker loose. I know it's not that big driver, but I can hear clutter a little bit anymore.
Yeah.
Every time he goes. Stainless steel pins they put down. I don't know if someone was sheared off or failed in holding the planks in place. I don't know. I mean, they're not flopping by any means because
they're huge, they're loose.
Yeah. But other than that, the bridges are pretty decent. I mean, other than them two, they're now inspecting our short bridges, 10 to 20 feet bridges. They've already done one on Warren Brook, and that one, other than the railings missing, that bridge is...
That's the one by the reservoir?
Yeah.
Are those included in the 13 total bridges?
No.
How many shorter bridges do we have?
I don't know, I've been working on that with him, but that's the only... Actually, they have one on Main Poland. He gave me a list of the ones, but he wasn't sure if they actually fell. There's one on Main Poland just past Jimmy Recoy's place. That's an 8-foot culvert, so it shouldn't...
Culvert, that's not a bridge.
Well, anything over 10 foot.
Oh, they're classifying?
From the center line. You know, if the pipe's going on an angle and it gets over 10 feet, then it becomes a bridge that they inspect.
Or that was my place a lot of years from now. I can remember when long before I came into town, right. They did that. So that's probably... It's got to be 30, 40 years ago. Maybe even 50 years ago they did that.
I don't know. I gave them the ones on... Fournier Road to put on their list to see if it's something that they will inspect. Mm-hmm. That one and the one on Matthews Road and Graves Road at the beginning, in the triangle there.
Oh, right, sure, yeah, okay.
I don't know whether they will or not, whether it fits the criteria, but I know there's money available there's not money yet, but there's proposed money to be available for fixing any of these
short
bridges. Although it sounds like that money's going to disappear in a hurry.
Well, it's $50 million for the entire state.
Right, yeah.
Wow, no, that isn't much.
Well, these are just for the short bridges.
That's under 20-foot bridges.
Under the 20-foot. Yeah. So, but it's also how they're going to divvy up that money. Because whether they do it by district or however, Boston's fighting, or the eastern part of the state's fighting hard to get the same percentage as what's needed out here. And it does, will hurt us if they equally divide by district.
Did they give any indication about the number one replacement bridge on North Palm that they would possibly be able to come up with a function on?
The number one bridge?
Yeah, number two bridge, maybe, would it be so bad?
They're very stingy in giving out any information about money being available for, and then I can't even find out how they put the bridge on the replacement list.
Well, the replacement, and I don't know if they still do, I don't, they probably don't do this anymore. We used to put it together, the towns put together replacement age of the bridges. Mm-hmm. And then as the council of governments came into effect after the county government collapsed, or got taken away by the state, I should say, then they formed a group of people at the council of governments. And one of our representatives from each town was on it, and he was very representative, pushing hard, and got that Millie Collins' bridge, the third bridge up, replaced. He got that bumped up a couple of years from being in that group, and knowing that bridge is in such poor shape, and that was held up by peers too. They finagled a way to get that moved ahead a couple of years. That's why that got done when it did. But I don't know if that group even exists anymore, or has anything to do with it.
Right now, the way the Transportation Improvement Program works is that roads are dealt with on the regional level. So the COG's Transportation Improvement Plan does include roads, but bridges are now dealt with only by the state's Transportation Improvement Plan.
Separate them, yeah.
So we do have to go to the state for that kind of assistance.
They're definitely separating. Okay.
Anything else, Ron?
As far as bridges, that's about it. I just want to just give a thing of what we have for proposed projects for this year coming up.
For what projects?
For proposed projects that we're planning to do in the next coming year. In East Guinea Road, we're planning on reclamation and blacktop for the blacktop section that's out there now with fixing any drainage issues.
There are places, I think, where water's coming up right in the middle of the road.
No, that was on Main Poland.
That was on Main Poland. Oh, yeah, okay.
That's a part that we already have reclaimed.
Oh, okay, good.
And hopefully in a month that will be paved. We still got quite a little work to do on Main Poland and North Poland to before July. Mm-hmm. So it's scheduled to be paved in the middle of June.
Okay.
So we still got some drainage work to do on North Poland. Main Poland, we got still got to put more gravel down and fix it, you know, drainage ditches and stuff out there before the blacktop. Mm-hmm. Hopefully, we're going to do something with Baptist and Upper Baptist and Cemetery Hill. Hopefully, we're going to reclaim that or grind it, mm-hmm. remove okay. the blacktop that's here, and then repave it. So I think we've been doing culvert analysis, trying to get all our roads so that I know what there is out there. There may be some issues where we may not be able to get to Baptist and Upper Baptist this year just because of the drainage issues that are there. Delabar Ave, I'm putting that on hold. That was planned to be reclaimed and blacked off, but putting that on hold until hopefully that whole section of road there gets redid. The water drainage issue gets addressed, and I'm pretty sure when we talked to the engineer that was all part of it.
When that gets engineered, is that a project you would work on, or is that?
Probably not, but I mean, there is that possibility because we still have seven, even if we get the grant, we're still going to be responsible for 75% at minimum, right?
I think
they pay 25%.
Yeah.
That's what I said. We're going to be responsible for
25%.
So I don't know if maybe that may be a way to offset that 25% is if we actually do the labor.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know whether it's a project that makes sense for us to do or not. But
do we have the kind of heavy equipment to deal with that bank?
They're going
to
go all the way down to the water, aren't they?
Well, it's amazing.
It's probably more, they shouldn't go all the way down to the water. Then they have to get the Army Corps of Engineers permit, which we have so far avoided. A lot of it's a question of how much time it takes, so that they're taken away from other work that they have to do.
Yeah. The equipment, the rentals, I mean, they're equipment about anything you need.
Okay.
And the other thing that I'm hoping to get taken care of is some drainage work on Hoosick, Matthews, and Orchard Street.
Have you all completed with the road? Is that totally complete?
No, we're going to hopefully be over there as soon as we get.
What do you got left to go there on?
Just finish up all the culvert heads. Mm-hmm. And guardrails.
That fire hydrant sign just up then.
What's that?
That's right, a construction sign just up.
Nope, signs are gone.
Really?
Yeah, they got moved to Poland Road. They've been gone since last fall.
You know, last fall somebody said, oh, the construction sign just up. I said, well, yeah, the fire's still working on that.
Mm-hmm. I took them down because we weren't doing anything over there, but we do have some work left.
But it's your intention to get that done this summer?
Yep.
Yeah, we should try to get these projects all completed up as we're moving forward.
Sure.
Instead of leaving a bunch of open ended.
Right. Thank you, Ron.
All right.
Thanks. Feels good, Trey. Thanks.
Okay, next item on our agenda is to approve the wedding reception for the town field.
Now, that said, they have not signed this new permit and application. So if you did that, then I could tell them that it's our intent to do it. They know what the process is. They just haven't signed the new policy that we have.
That we now have.
So, yes.
What's the dates on the wedding?
That's August.
It's 20th, right? 20th. August
20th.
20th. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think they have.
Maybe something to approve it pending their.
We have our bases covered. Of in terms of what we have to do and our liability is covered on that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Ken's involved.
Yeah.
Okay. We need any ambulance down there or anything like that?
Well, if we do, it'll be a 911 call.
Okay.
It's a private party? No, that's a good way to ruin a wedding, having an ambulance sitting there.
Well, you never can tell.
Is that standard for wedding season? I don't know.
Could be.
Got a party we haven't done yet.
Tie the cans on the back.
All right, so right now we'll approve that preliminarily on everything pending their signing, whatever they need to sign for us, and covering our liabilities. So I'll move that we approve that with the pending pending their signing our application for that.
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Hey, Tony, how are you?
Is somebody coming from Frog tonight?
Yes. Yep, they should be here any minute. Okay. Come on in, have a seat. Next item on the agenda is the 5K race sponsored by the Conway Grammar School on May 22nd. That's this Sunday.
Yes, right? It is. They planned it, and I just found out about it recently.
Okay.
So I let them know please give us a longer heads up. They arranged this with Ken. I don't know what their route is, but they did. I guess they talked to they talked to you.
No, they talked to Kenny and Ronnie.
Do we know we know their route?
I believe it's from the ball field up Maple Street, across the covered bridge. I think Kenny talked him into coming down the sidewalk and crossing in front of Sunset Package Store instead of going up behind by the church.
Good idea.
And then going up Ives Road, and I think they're coming, not sure where they're coming here, but I think they're ending back at the ball field.
They're staying off 116.
The only place they'd probably be on it is right here, crossing right here. I'm guessing, I'm not 100% sure.
I think I'll go down Shelby Falls, go up down the street, huh?
How many participants do we have?
I don't think there's very many. It's just
Kenny
our
said,
school.
Right now, it's just open to the school community.
Right, right.
Kenny said they tentatively think they got 60 students signed up for.
Okay, but we're keeping them off 116.
Well, I can't vouch for that 100%.
Kenny's approved the route with them, so he's all aware of it.
5K, so that's 3.5 miles. So there's going to be some spread to this thing. Do we know?
Kenny was up fine with everything.
And the school has certain people who are going to be involved in supervising this?
I'm assuming. I know they talked to Kenny first.
I know the AMLS has been notified about it, so that they make sure to get somebody available to head to.
Because we're going to have little kids involved in this, correct?
Yeah.
It's the grammar school.
It's
so
the grammar school.
It's
yeah.
like, what, kindergarten to six?
Yeah. Yes.
And Kenny's okay with this?
Yep. Sure.
Okay. According to this letter, they're just making us aware of this.
Yes, and I have asked them to give us a heads up and know that I had it on the agenda for tonight for your approval.
For our approval?
I'm strongly suggesting they ask us for earlier next time so that we can get all of these questions answered more than a week before the event.
Maybe there should be a policy made for people doing things like this so they know what to do. Because I'm pretty sure they went to Kenny first, and Kenny didn't think there was any issue as far as the town.
Well, then I'm not sure that we need to give them our approval. Why don't we just...
Well, we gave approval to Caitlin Burnett for her.
Yeah, she also gave us 6 months' notice.
Right. It would be good to formally approve it so that.
We could give them approval pending that next year if they do it. Give them a minimum amount of time to get notified.
Or make a policy of when somebody's going to have something involves the street.
They did say they would be happy to let us know earlier next year. They didn't.
Okay.
I think it's just a matter
of think of it.
Well, I think it's just a matter of they didn't know what the procedure was for doing it.
All right, I'll make a motion that we approve the concept of this run and the route that's been approved by our chief. Does that have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, next item is approve a town administrator taking the date of the select board meeting of May 31 as a vacation day. You gave us this date a long time ago.
Yeah.
We approved it already, basically. Well,
no, we didn't. You just mentioned it a week or two.
Yeah, so.
I don't have a problem with it.
It is.
Yeah. You had given us this date a while back.
Yeah, and if it weren't the date of a select board meeting, I wouldn't ask for your formal approval,
but you're
since
gonna be
it is.
Partying down on the Cape, is that it?
Well, I will be working hard down on the Cape.
So it means we'll be having a meeting without you.
Yes, and Liz will also not be present at that meeting. So Joyce is going to do all the warrant work, so you'll have the
right
warrant numbers and things like that. But Liz will prepare some proto minutes for you that you can sort of fill out and make it easier.
Like last time, that worked out pretty well.
We'll work on that.
All right, yeah, we'll approve. I'll make a motion that we approve you are taking the 31st off as a vacation day. We have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Still, we don't have Peggy here, so we'll go on. Next item on the agenda is items not anticipated 48 hours in advance of the meeting. Okay, we had and I'm not going to discuss it in detail or specifics, but just generally, we had an application for the Zoning Board of Appeals, and as I was reviewing Massachusetts General Law 40A, which covers the Zoning Board of Appeals, we need to have three members to have a zoning board. We only have two members on that board now. And in that case, that reverts to the select board to be the Zoning Board of Appeals until we can approve a third member to the official Zoning Board of Appeals. So there has been, I had posted a meeting for this Thursday at 8 a.m. Is that something that either of you can make? 8 a.m. on Thursday?
Thursdays are good.
Okay. Thursday morning, 8 a.m. right here.
Sounds good.
And essentially, we'll just look over this application.
Thursday the 19th?
Thursday's the 19th. Is that good? Okay, and what we'll do is just a cursory review of this, and then we have to go through a very formal procedure of noticing this for a public hearing. So this is just a cursory review at this point, just to get this into motion. And Mark Silverman and I are the two members of the ZBA that isn't an official ZBA at this point. We need to get a third member of that. And I know you have put it out that we need a member, right, Tom? In your
announcements? We have a list on the website of a number of positions that are open.
Okay. So I would suggest that Mark be involved with us on Thursday morning so that he knows what's going on. But again, this is just a cursory review and discussion of this, because we do have to have it out to a public hearing. Okay, next item, Tom, your update.
Just a couple of items, actually. First, the State Department of Public Health started looking at the building that's River Road, the superintendent's building for the school.
It's the administration building.
Yeah, the administration building, and that's what that is all about. It's air quality issues and mitigation costs in that building. It's not the Conway Grammar School. It's the It's the administration building. Sorry. They're looking at some reasonably costly, let's say, $100,000 or $200,000 for.
Do we own that building?
Addressing
both. Do we rent from the town of Whitley?
Which building are we talking about?
This is the administration building, the Frontier Administration.
Christian Lane building. And River Road. I think it's Christian Lane.
Yeah,
isn't it?
I thought
we rented it from the town of Whitley.
That's the administration building for Frontier.
Right, yes.
Right.
So your old grammar school.
Yeah.
Old.
Right. Okay.
So, and I don't see anything from Peggy here on. Originally, we'd scheduled Peggy. I'm just checking to see for the Woodlands Trail Partnership Program. Originally, we'd scheduled that for the Conway Grammar School, so I'm hoping she didn't go there tonight.
Do we have her number?
No, I don't have a number for her. I did try calling her, but it was just 5, and she didn't pick up. So that's something. I have the full report if anybody wants to look at it. I suggest you do look at it. It's got a lot of
mold issues,
specific
probably, right?
Costs.
We're talking about
a
the
lot
administration
of issues.
Buildings. There's a problem with the air quality.
Yes. Potential bird waste throughout the system, other lots of odors in the bathrooms. And people are reporting physical symptoms. So it's potential will need a special town meeting. I mean, this is not something that I think they're thinking is going to wait for a year.
Yeah, how come we didn't get something before now on this?
Well, the report just came out. It was just reported to the Conway Grammar School Committee.
There wasn't any preliminary report on this?
I don't.
Because you know, usually these studies take a while. You know.
Well, this was what the State Department of Public Health managed to do. I don't know how long it took them to do it. Maybe it says that in the report. I skipped right to the numbers.
So what numbers are we talking about here?
Well, $100,000 or $200,000, depending on how much work they actually do.
Okay.
And it could be more. That's there are very specific things they do in different levels that they talk about addressing it at. So there's a basic level, and then there's a more inclusive level. So,
okay. So worst case, we're talking $200,000. Give her the approximate number, Tom. Don't go crazy here.
Well, I gave her the approximate number I know.
Okay. And what's our share of that?
We're about 6.
It's actually more than that. Sorry, the couple hundred thousand is for the basic. Well, 150 for 800 for the general work. Then there's another 450 that would include renovating the entire building.
Another $450,000
for renovating the entire building.
Okay.
Yeah. Most of which would be $150,000 for an accessibility upgrade, the elevator to allow meetings on all floors, and office and space renovation. So it's not sort of directly relevant to the immediate issue, but if they're going to do the abatement work for $150,000. And improve the building to a certain extent, it might make sense also to fold it into a larger contract that could be done by a single company.
Yeah. What's our share of that? Do we know?
Well, would it be about is Deerfield half of Frontier costs, or
Deerfield's about half,
and so the rest are equally split.
Sunderland's about another 25%. So
okay.
Of that, the remaining 25, I think Waitley and I, so we're maybe 12.5%, about 1/8 of that, right?
Yeah.
So we'd be talking about $50,000 to $55,000, give or take.
Minimum 25,000 for the first
right.
bit, or probably 30 by the time it's done, and you know, maximum 80 plus.
When are they suggesting that this get done?
It's causing physical symptoms now. So
we're talking about
as close to immediate
tomorrow,
as we can.
So over the this, summer,
which is why I'm saying that we will need a special town meeting.
My only concern here is this just didn't happen.
That's right. This had to
why
be.
Why wasn't this brought up at budget hearing time?
Capital improvement.
Cabinet Plumer time.
Yeah.
I mean, somebody. I shouldn't say playing games. That doesn't sound good.
The date of the assessment was February 25th.
Sure.
And this report was just published in April, mid-April.
Mid-April.
So February, March.
And we just got a copy of it.
It was just presented to the Conway Grammar School Committee last week.
Yeah. This is a health issue, like they claim it is, that they should get out of the building immediately.
So it's mid-May now. So February to March to April. April. The main school got it, which was too late to get it into.
We didn't get any word that this was coming down the line from anybody. Mm,
that's strange.
No, they asked. No, they. It was done in February, so my guess is it came to a head over the winter.
Sure.
When people were, you know.
Mm-hmm. No, the windows open.
In the building. Yeah, none of the windows were open.
Okay. Thank you, Tom. So
pass that along for your information.
So we may be having a special town meeting very shortly on this. What's the required action on this from us?
Well, I think this is why the superintendent brought it to the Conway Grammar School Committee, was for their attention and recommendation. So
okay.
I think they're taking the lead on deciding what to do and when. I'm sure there will be some kind of a four-town meeting at some point, you know.
Why don't we have the school committee come in and talk to us about this?
All right.
Okay. And you're talking to DOE, or you're talking to Terry Williams?
No, we went right to the attorneys.
Okay.
This is for the amended motion for the fire truck to authorize the treasurer and the select board either to lease or to borrow money. According to our accountant, borrowing money for a lease is not permitted. We will now have to see whether the motion as a whole can be considered legal, since it included the impermissible clause. I don't actually foresee a problem with that, but we have yet to hear back from DOR. So that's where we stand right now.
All right, why don't we have capital improvements get us some real numbers on a leasing option?
We will not be able to lease.
At all?
No.
We can't. Okay, so it's just the buy option. All right, we already approved
at this
that.
Point. Yeah.
All right.
Unless we had the extra money from the borrowing article, we wouldn't be able to sign a lease. We have to have all of the money up front in order to sign a contract.
Yeah. Okay.
And because we can't borrow money to lease, then there's no source of funds. There's no source of that $151,000 except for borrowing.
Mm-hmm.
The way, you know, that's the way the motion was made and amended. And,
okay.
Yeah.
Right. Anything else, Tom?
No.
Okay.
Everything else is on the agenda.
Thank you. Okay. Concerns of the selectmen. Any concerns, Bob? I'll call you Robin. I'll call you Bob. How's
okay,
that?
It's okay.
Any concerns?
Not that I can think of right.
No concerns tonight. And you're here your first night. You have no concerns.
I can't
either.
Not
okay.
Yet.
That's good. All right, man.
First one here, I'm here at 8 in the morning.
I should. This question will go to Ron. You mentioned to Tom 2 weeks ago about concerns of the street sign straightened up.
Working on it.
Good man.
It is the state's responsibility.
Well, not only the state's. Some of our own.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. But the Whately Road sign in all the state, any state where the road is, any town road that meets the state is responsible for the signage.
It is, but they made the town economy back when we did the streetscapes. Those round black posts, they made the town economy buy all those black posts.
They just dropped off. We're actually going to put the weight.
They still got some of them left?
They just dropped off what we need to put that post
up. They were housing over in Buckland at the state.
It took me 2 weeks to finally talk to the right guy. But I got a hold of him and I talked to him today. And
they made us buy them, but they took them away and housed them. That's a little different. Huh? We suggested, well, we can find a place to house them. No, I think we can.
Okay. Those are still there.
Those are still there.
All right. In the mail, we got a letter from Maya. They are giving us a credit, a participation credit of $1,229. They're giving us money back. This is good.
I think we may actually get more than that. That's for all the activity this fiscal year, and that did not include an event, a Maya event that I went to last week. So we may actually be getting more than that.
That's good.
Oh,
that's great.
What's Maya?
Maya is the Massachusetts
Interlocal
Insurance Association. We get some of our insurance through them. And there's also a letter in here that's addressed to Lee that I'll just leave in the folder for right now.
The select board was copied on it, right?
Yeah. Okay, any announcements? No announcements. Okay. I don't know where Peggy is.
Neither do I, and
I would have assumed that she would have called us.
Is this a pressing issue?
Yeah.
Not
so much.
Not really?
But they do have to. They do want to move it along. So I'll see whether or not they might be able to come at 31st.
Woodland Partnership Program.
Yeah.
Well, was this something to do with the merging of all the properties?
Yes. This is a new model for the Forest Service, the way the Silvio Conti Wildlife Refuge was a new model for Fish and Wildlife, where instead of it being one chunk of land that they set aside, it's an area within which people can set aside land for forest purposes.
Mm-hmm.
This is...
Go ahead,
no, okay. Oh, well.
But the land would still be owned by the held by the landowner. So they'd be conservation restrictions rather than purchases of the land.
How does that affect the tax rate, or doesn't it?
It probably wouldn't affect it if the property's in 61, but it might affect it if it were not in 61. That'd be my guess.
Because I know Fish and Wildlife just took on a good-sized chunk of land up there. We approved it on the North Fall Road.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And now I understand they're looking at maybe even bigger parcel on the off of East Guinea Road. And that come out to petrol?
Yeah. It gets reduced, yeah.
Yeah, that's a different situation, because in this situation, the ownership would still remain with the individual who owns the land. The Forest Service isn't purchasing the land. It's my understanding.
Mm-hmm.
But by having people taking individual...
Just to protect the land more, is that it?
It's a way the Forest Service can protect the forest without buying... Because, you know, originally they had the idea of bringing the Green Mountain State Forest on down into Massachusetts, and that met a lot of opposition. They didn't want the federal government buying up land and so forth. So this is...
My only concern, I'm sure you're probably just like yours, when we start cutting down tax rates in the town of Conway because of these different type of little programs, every time we cut down tax rate, his, yours, mine, and everybody else's house taxes go up.
course, the argument on the other side is that if that land doesn't get developed, then it won't require additional services.
I understand that, but
I know it's the same. It's the same old soul.
We have a only a certain pot of money that we have to divide amongst our taxpayers.
In June. Sorry, I bumped it up.
Okay.
So
it'll be coming next month.
Okay.
This was the original date that we had had.
Okay.
And then we bumped it a couple of times.
Okay. Well, so I got an email to this. Okay. Nice meeting with you all.
So yeah.
Welcome to the new.
Thank you.
Nice seeing you, Tony. You're here representing
the Open Space Committee?
No, I'm here. I'm involved with the Franklin Land Trust.
I know it.
And so I'm. And they're supporting the program.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for coming, Tony.
Yes, sir.
Good seeing you.
Sorry about that. I will give you the.
It's not your problem. I got an email today from. Not from you, but from Franklin Land Trust.
So. Oh, okay.
All righty.
Guess they're keeping tabs.
Okay, next item on the agenda. Our next meeting is for Tuesday, the 31st. That's right here at 7 o'clock. There's no more business to come before the board. I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you, Liz.